Thank you very much. Mr. P.S. Mishra, Member Operations and Business Development, Railway Board. Mr. Naresh Salicha, Member Finance, Railway Board. My good friend and colleague and the captain of the ship today, Mr. V. Kalyan Raman, the Chairman and Managing Director of Concor, who is steering the current initiative and taking it to the right shore at high speed, but with full precautions. My compliments to you, Mr. Kalyan Ramanji, for this wonderful initiative that you have taken. Mr. Yatish Kumar, Managing Director of Braithwaite Company Limited, who had first flagged off this concept and issue in the review meeting of Braithwaite. I'm grateful to him for having taken all of us a little bit by surprise by showing how a railway wagon company, manufacturer or repair company, was venturing to look at a product which frankly all of us should have been looking at for years to come. Mr. Jitendra Das, General Manager of BHEL, also getting involved in the manufacture of containers. Mr. Piyush Gupta, Vice President of Tata Steel. All the other friends who have joined this conversation about indigenous container manufacturing. I believe you've already had one session prior to this and one is going to be held in the subsequent period. Of course, I would have liked to be there in the opening session itself, but we have another parallel program going on the production linked incentive scheme of 10 or 13 sectors. And I was unable to kickstart your discussion, but I'm really delighted to be a part of our discussion in this session. It's a great platform for all the stakeholders to explore newer opportunities to manufacture containers in India. And I'm sure all stakeholders, be there our steel manufacturers, I think they'll have to contribute by also developing this Corten 6 steel, which is required for container manufacturing. I'm told it's right. But I do hope our steel makers call Corten A steel required. It's about more than 80% of the steel requirement in a container. But I'm sure the steel manufacturers' representatives who are with us today will take note of that. And all the other stakeholders who are on the call today will recognize the huge opportunity that indigenous manufacturing of containers has to offer. You must have all heard that old saying, never put all your eggs in one basket. And sadly, in container manufacturing, we have no basket of our own. Not only are all our eggs are in one basket, but that basket is also not ours. It is outside the country. And in recent times, even Concor had difficulty getting their requirement of containers in time. And across the world today, there's a global shortage of containers. While figures were given of 8,000 Concor requirement, 3,000-4,000 others, my own sense is we should be aspiring for a much, much bigger play in container manufacturing. After all, we have absolutely excellent steel making capabilities in India. We have a good MSME sector with very good skills, who can produce the rest of the components, the hinges and locks and all of that. And the actual frame making is something that all our wagon companies, our railway factories, at least, and there must be many more, our auto companies, all have capabilities. Probably if we explore, we'll find 100 companies in India who can help us in the fabrication of containers within India. And we have to look big and bold because India's Atmanirbhar Bharat story has just begun. Mishra ji just mentioned, or you also, Salecha ji, mentioned our exports are overtaking imports, and that story will continue. It will not continue. I hope it will accelerate. While we may continue to import oil, but on many other products which are currently coming from abroad, you will find that gradually imports will peter down. The production linked incentive scheme also, about which the earlier program was going on. There's a lot of excitement and buzz in our manufacturing sector, both to meet domestic needs and to meet international requirement and be a part of resilient global supply chains, which are looking at alternate suppliers. And therefore, our exports, my sense is, are certainly going to increase significantly as against our imports. Secondly, the government has made a conscious decision to support our shipping sector so that more and more of our Indian companies start owning Indian flagged vessels. We give more business to our Indian shipping companies. I believe that certain programs are being devised by the shipping ministry in consultation with shipping lines, which will give a big boost, leg up to our shipping sector. We are paying about $50 billion every year, an estimate has been put before me. $50 billion in foreign exchange for the freight costs and all the related ancillary costs for our import and export. Even if half of that has to be kept in India or done value addition in India, imagine the huge potential for the shipping industry and correspondingly for companies like Concor and container manufacturers and owners. So my sense is, if we can get all our, and our wagon demand has fallen significantly because we are now more efficient. Railways, if you move your freight at twice the speed, what was the pre-COVID level, and we are committed to maintain it, rather improve it in the months to come. We are at 46 kilometers. We want to go up to 50 and then aspire for better goals. We'll be comparable to the rest of the world. So our wagon requirement, my guesses, will correspondingly reduce with faster turnaround of cargo in the railway system. And therefore, our wagon manufacturers may also like to consider venturing into container manufacturing. My belief is that as the volumes become big, it will become a viable business proposition. If you are trying to do costing on 100, 200, 50, 5, 5,000, 1,000, you may not find it very attractive. But I am one who believes that scale presents huge cost benefit opportunities. If you produce a high quality product, our neighbors will never be able to match it. And that can be sold in Europe, in America, in a big way. If India starts, let's say, manufacturing 1 million containers a year, then we will become cost competitive to sell to all parts of the world. Why should Maersk and APL and all these big lines not be buying Indian containers? I would look at this exercise that you have started as just the beginning of a big aspiration. And I think the container manufacturing business needed a lift, which Concor has been kind enough to provide. By lift, I mean making our logistics more efficient, dependent on indigenous sources, plan for the future, make it futuristic, and set the trend, become a trendsetter. Then more and more sectors start becoming self-reliant. That's the lift that Concor has given to the indigenous container manufacturers. Logistics becoming efficient, indigenous, futuristic, and trend-setting. And I'm grateful to Kalyan Raman and his team, and to Braithwaite and BHEL for having supported each other, taken up this challenge, and I would like to see all of you work as a team, not looking at counting the pennies, कि 2,000 रुपया सस्ता हो गया, 1,000 रुपया महंगा हो गया, इस पे मत जाइए। आप इंडिया को कंटेनर कैपिटल ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बनाने की सोचिए, इंडिया को कंटेनर फैक्ट्री ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बनाने की सोचिए। और आपको अगर कोई इंडस्ट्री से सहयोग चाहिए तो मैं बात करने के लिए तैयार हूं, जिससे भी आप चाहो, टू मेक इट मोर कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव, और छोटा मोटा कम ज्यादा दाम भी हो तो एक भारत की शान भी तो होती है। भारत में बने हुए कंटेनर में हमारा सामान जाएगा, हमारा भी तो सीना सबका चौड़ा होना चाहिए ना इस बात पर। हम कैसे निर्भर हो सकते हैं दूसरे देशों पे एक साधारण से कंटेनर बनाने में। और मुझे लगता है कि अब ये कंटेनर शॉर्टेज और इंपोर्टेड कंटेनर, इट शुड बी डंप्ड इनटू द फ्लेम्स ऑफ हिस्ट्री। वी शुड ऑल कलेक्टिवली टेक अ कॉन्क्रीट डिसीजन, वी विल बाय ओनली इंडियन एंड वी विल सपोर्ट इंडियन इंडस्ट्री, वील हेल्प देम बिकमिंग कॉस्ट एफिशिएंट, डिजाइन गुड कंटेनर्स, हाई क्वालिटी कंटेनर्स, एंड नॉट ओनली नीड इंडियाज मीट इंडियाज नीड्स बट द वर्ल्ड्स नीड्स इन द मंथ्स टू कम। एंड दैट्स द ओनली सक्सेस फॉर्मूला। Unless we aim to conquer the world, we will not get any transformative results. So my appeal to all on this call is, let's set our aim high. And if we want to be successful in our aim, we'll have to automate, we'll have to innovate, and we'll have to manufacture. That should be our aim. Automate these processes, innovate or invent better designs, and manufacture efficiently in India. I would appeal to all the steel industry also to support us by manufacturing Corten A steel in India, so that that part doesn't have to be import dependent. I'd like to ask all our wagon manufacturers to consider manufacturing in India. Maybe Concor could consider giving all those who want to develop this that initial 1,000-piece order at the same price at which Braithwaite and BHEL are making, or go through a competitive bidding short process, not very long process, and discover the price through competitive bidding, but give out 8, 10, 20,000 containers orders. After all, it will take time to develop. You will require it in that much time. But give them freedom to develop, to speed up the development. If you get more containers, you can have more of your own. Reduce your dependence on hiring others' containers. After all, you're moving more than 4 lakh containers every year. Push your own containers. You'll get additional charges also. And it's not a very high-tech industry. It's not rocket science to make containers. But today, the problem we are facing of containers is actually affecting exports. Rice, wheat, sugar, all are suffering because we don't have enough containers. Kalyan Raman, you may consider getting not 1 or 2 lakh containers. That will not help. We need 1 million containers in India. Just sugar, rice and wheat will require probably 500,000 containers.
Sir, yes sir.
Right. So I would urge you to quickly discuss with all the shipping lines and if necessarily barge empty containers into India.
But, yeah, doing that, sir.
We cannot, but speed it up. We need much more, sir. Because we cannot lose the export opportunity. We have surplus sugar stock. Our rice production is high quality. It's wanted all over the world. There's food shortages in other parts of the world. Great opportunity to earn foreign exchange. You will get business, railways will get business, country will get foreign exchange, farmers will be benefited. Look at the multifarious benefits of it. So please get some empty containers quickly into the country and meet all the sugar, wheat, rice requirement amongst others. Simultaneously, anybody and everybody, in fact, even our 3 coach factories. After all, Pudendu, you are aware that going forward, our coach factories will also need to diversify a little bit. Given the fact that the speed at which we have grown our production and become efficient will need more work. How will you keep your workforce busy otherwise? And we have large factories. You literally dedicate one shed in each factory and make containers, hundreds of them every day. They become large container manufacturers. So I would urge everybody to work in this team to make India a preferred destination for supply of containers, and with volume and with high-tech processes, I'm sure we can keep our costs low and meet the world's demands at competitive prices. At some stage, if there's any problem on costing, I'm always there. You can come back to me. After 3 months, we can do a review meeting, by which time some work would have been done by Bale and Braithwaite, possibly by some other wagon manufacturers or railway factories also. Railway has so many workshops, which now don't have enough work because your periodicity of maintenance has changed. Can some of these workshops become container manufacturers? Give it to BHEL, give it to Braithwaite to use those facilities and make it. Use innovative ways to use our surplus capacity, our large sheds, the workers that we have who are gradually, their efficiency will come down otherwise. They'll try to fill up the time with less work. Right? So you'll have to immediately act to keep everybody busy and keep the efficiency of our railway systems intact. So, ladies and gentlemen, Indian Railways is a vehicle of service for the nation. And Atmanirbhar Bharat will be incomplete without this contribution that Railways is trying to steer. It's not a directly related activity of Railways. Comes more under my Department for Promoting Indian Industry function as Commerce and Industry Minister. But I look at the synergies. I have food procurement and the disposal of all our surplus stocks in my control. I am facing a shortage of containers. As DPIIT, I want to promote indigenous manufacture of containers as Commerce and Industry Minister. As Railways, CONCOR has that opportunity to give me that push. Railways moves lakhs of containers every year. DFC will come in by next year. So hopefully we'll do much more business in Railways on containers. And then you'll be moving containers in one day to the port from anywhere along the DFC. Your average freight as a railway will improve even further, the speed and all. So you look at the potential going forward. To my mind, I see endless potential. And let's, all of us, work together as a team. Let's look at refrigerated containers. That's also going to become important going forward. Braithwaite and Bale, please note. Wagon companies, please note. Our factories also know how to do refrigerated wagons or air-conditioned wagons. We can go one step further. We should look at GPS-enabled containers across the country. Logistics division is also under me in Commerce. Talk to them and see if we can make it compulsory that any container coming into India should be GPS-enabled. So we can really track at all times what's happening. Chori karne ki bhi sambhavna kam ho jayegi. So, Purnendu, you take up this mission with logistics. All containers in India to be GPS-enabled. And in 3 or 4 months, we can do it. It's not a very difficult process. If a new container comes at the port, if it is not GPS-enabled, before unloading it, it should be compulsory. It has to be made GPS-enabled. It's a very small equipment, hardly costs anything. We can use mobile technology. We can even use satellite technology. Now, that is also allowed for tracking. We're having opened up the sector recently under Atmanirbhar Bharat. So, ladies and gentlemen, this team, for me, is a very precious team which is on the call today. You can do wonders You can become the lifeline of India's industry. You have to aim high. You have to lift the spirits of Atmanirbhar Bharat. And I have no doubt that Kalyan Ramanji's team, the team at Braithwaite and BHEL, our wagon manufacturers and factories, our steel and other component manufacturers, this entire team has the potential to make this program a success. Please be bold. Please be wise. Please be futuristic in your thinking. But let's go for it and make this program a grand success. My best wishes to all of you, from the government, from the private sector, from our PSUs. Let us all make Prime Minister Narendra Modi's mission and vision of Atmanirbhar Bharat a grand success, and let us make our indigenous container manufacturing program the start of one more journey towards making India self-sufficient and ensuring that India never has a shortage of containers ever, ever in the future. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.